Hi, everyone. Welcome back. Today, we're going to cover arguably one of the most intelligent tools in our app, AutoTrace. We've had this feature for a few years now, but we've just released a new update, which I'm sure you'll find very cool. So let's start. First of all, you need to know that AutoTrace is a content-aware feature. So while it's not visible now in our Style tab, it automatically appears once an image is selected. You can also access it in the Quick Actions menu down here. The exact same options appear if we tap on this button, but more on that later. With our latest update, AutoTrace can now be used in two different modes, photography and sketch. For the photography mode, we have this cool astronaut image here to demo on, and I'm going to use Quick Actions for convenience. So, tap on the image, tap on AutoTrace, and we see these two parameters, complexity and minimum path size. You can just auto-trace the image without making any changes to these sliders. Wait a few seconds. And this is the result. It now has this beautiful painting aesthetic, and it's made up of dozens of vector paths that combine to create this effect. But let's move on to our second mode. We like to call this sketch trace. I imported a sketch from Unsplash. It's a royalty-free platform available directly in Vectornator, and you can just import any image or sketch you want from there. Of course, you can also just snap a photo of your own sketchbook or simply import directly from raster-based softwares like Procreate. Now, when we select this image, we can see that Vectornator already changed the auto-trace mode to sketch. That's because our AI recognized that this image is, in fact, a sketch. Here, the two editing parameters are also different. We have complexity. The lower this value, the more objects are going to be grouped or clustered together. So if we hit auto-trace now, this is what we get. But let's undo and see how we can make this better. So let's look at contrast. Contrast indicates at which point a color is considered black or white. Higher values will make more colors black and vice versa. To get the best results, just experiment with these two sliders on a case-by-case basis. I decided to go with 60% complexity and 45% contrast. And here's what we get. The result is pretty impressive. You can see just how close the vector paths are to the original sketch. And now, they can be edited infinitely in our app. The sky is truly the limit. But let's see another type of sketch. This one has a lot more black to it. So if we go to the auto-trace sketch mode settings, I'm making complexity 30% and contrast 50% to get these results. Of course, there's a lot of black, but since it's a vector, it can easily be removed. Or I can color in my tiger with whatever color I want. You can make it orange or just go crazy with neon. Finally, let's see how we can auto-trace lettering. I have this neat Monday motivation quote here. Just select it, go to auto-trace, and then switch from photography to sketch mode. And I'm going to turn up my complexity to 90% just because of the background and all these details in the handwriting. The contrast we also keep high because I want to preserve all these black values here in these letters. Let's hit it. Boom. This is what we get. A super crisp vector graphic that is almost identical to the hand-drawn typography we had before. I'm going to remove all the noise around by simply selecting some shapes and tapping on delete. And now, I can also change my colors as I want, edit my nodes, change to brush paths, all of it. But I'll leave all the experimenting to you guys. Hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure to like, comment, subscribe, have fun creating, and tag us on all your auto-trace creations on Instagram.